Hello dear students, let us understand about the protein synthesis. In this video, we will learn about the various components that are involved in the translation process. These are mainly three components, RNA, tRNA and mRNA. So, ribosomes are the basic platform where the translation occurs. So, in prokaryotes, we have a 70S type of ribosome. So this 70S ribosome is consist of two subunits, 50S large subunit and 30S small subunit. 50S large subunit again consists of rRNA. There are two types of rRNA, 23S rRNA and 5S rRNA, and there are about 31 different types of protein. In smaller subunit, we have 16S rRNA and about 20 protein. We have 80S ribosomes, which are consist of 60S and 40S two subunits. 60S subunit consists of 28S rRNA, 5S rRNA, and 5.8S rRNA. So there are three rRNA in larger subunit and about 40 proteins. The smaller subunit consists of 18S rRNA and 30 different proteins. So ribosomes consist of mainly rRNA and proteins. So next is tRNA. tRNA serve as an adapter in translating the language of the nucleic acid into the language of the protein. It is basically a single strand RNA which is folded into a precise 3D structure. The nucleotide number ranges from 73 to 93 nucleotides in each tRNA, and each tRNA contain unique amino acid, and therefore minimum 20 amino acids are 20 tRNA are required in the cell. However, cell have 32 different tRNA. The tRNA consists of amino acid branch which carries the amino acid. So the sequence of the amino acid arm is later on processed and it is fixed. It is known as C, C and A, and 5' end of the tRNA is modified and it consists of a guanylate residue. Then we have anticodon loop here. This loop bind with the codon sequence of the mRNA. Then we have a ribothymidine and pseudouridine in this loop. Pseudouridine are basically such type of uracil which have a different carbon nitrogen bond between the base and ribosugar, and ribothymidine, as you know, that thymine is not present in the RNA, but in case of tRNA we have a thymine present in the RNA. So this is known as ribothymidine. Then we have a D arm which contains the dihydrouridine in the D arm. Then we have another variable arm which is different, or the size of this extra arm is variable in different tRNA types. So this is the basic structure of the tRNA. However, in cell, the 3D structure of the tRNA is something different. It is known as clover leaf structure, as you can see in this right diagram. tRNA basically carries the amino acid and it bind with the codon sequence of the mRNA. So this is the ribosome, red color. Ribosome consists of rRNA. This is mRNA, and the tRNA serve as an adapter between the amino acid and the codon sequence of the mRNA. Then next is the attachment of the amino acid to the respective their tRNA. So this is carried out by the a class of enzymes that is known as aminoacyl tRNA synthetase. Different types of aminoacyl tRNA synthetase are known, which have their own unique tRNA and their own unique amino acid. So since there are 20 amino acids that are essential in the protein, so at least 20 different types of aminoacyl tRNA synthetase should be present in the cell, but more than 32 aminoacyl tRNA synthetase have been characterized. It was first proposed by the Paul Zemnick and Hoffman that amino acids are somehow activated during the protein synthesis. And later, Robert Holley characterized the tRNA. So basically, these enzymes attach the amino acid to their respective tRNA. So there are two class of the aminosyl tRNA synthetase, depending upon the reaction intermediate. But basically, they attach the amino acid to the tRNA. So what is the mechanism of attachment? So first, the amino acid bind with the active site in the aminosyl tRNA synthetase enzyme, and also binds with the ATP. Then this ATP is hydrolyzed and pyrophosphate is released, and this AMP is then combined with the amino acid. So this is the first reaction in which the amino acid is now activated. Then next, the tRNA comes and bind with this enzyme, and then this tRNA replaces the AMP and bind with the amino acid. So this is how the tRNA is activated, or tRNA attached with the amino acid, and this amino acid tRNA synthetase is released. And since each amino acid tRNA synthetase can bind with their tRNA, so there are more than 32 different types of amino acid tRNA synthetase that have been characterized. So this is how the amino acid is attached to the tRNA. This is the tRNA. This is the terminal adenosine residue. So this 3' hydroxyl group of the ribose sugar of the adenosine residue bind with the amino acid. So this is the amino acid. We have a carboxyl group, amino group. This is side chain, which is variable in different amino acid, and this is hydrogen. So this carboxyl bind with the 3' hydroxyl group, and this is how the amino acid attached to the tRNA. The next, mRNA. The mRNA contain one sequence which is known as Shine-Dalgrenau sequence in the prokaryotes. So this Shine-Dalgrenau sequence bind with the 16S rRNA. The 3' side of the 16S rRNA contain a complementary sequence of the Shine-Dalgrenau sequence. And complementary base pairing between the Shine-Dalgrenau sequence and 16S rRNA place the first AUG codon at the P site of the ribosome. So correct positioning of the first codon is ensured by the Shine-Dalgrenau sequence. In eukaryote, this is a different mechanism. Eukaryote ribosome scan the entire mRNA, and when it encounter with the first AUG codon, it starts the translation. So here in prokaryote, Shine-Dalgrenau sequence play important role in identification of the first codon, while in eukaryote, scanning of the mRNA is playing an important role in identification of the AUG codon. How the scanning is done in eukaryotes? So as you know, that mRNA of the eukaryote consists of different modification like 5' cap and poly A tail. So 5' cap is bind with the initiation factor. E stands for eukaryotes. So initiation factor 4E bind with the 5' cap. And poly A binding protein bind with the poly A tail. Then initiation factor 4G bind with the this 4E and poly A binding protein. So this makes a circular mRNA. And then this complex then interact with the initiation factor 3, and then initiation factor 3 bind with the 40S or smaller ribosomal unit. So this ribosome then scan the mRNA. This is a circular form of the mRNA, and this ribosome scan the mRNA, and when it encounter a COSAC sequence in the mRNA, so this COSAC sequence is the first identification sequence in the mRNA, which carries the start codon in the mRNA. So COSAC sequence help in the identification of the start codon in the eukaryotes, while Shine-Dalgrenau sequence help in identification of the start codon in the prokaryotes. So this is all in this video. We have learned about the ribosomes, different component of the ribosomes, then structure of the tRNA, then how the tRNA is activated or bind with the amino acid. Then third, we have learned about the structure of the mRNA or how the AUG codon is identified in the prokaryote and eukaryotes. Thank you so much for watching this video.